get the mic and start praising God. Hallelujah. You that's standing on the altar, glory to God, just join in. Amen. Isn't that wonderful?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. We made major progress. Hallelujah. In 4 years.
Amen.
We made major progress. And if you, glory to God, can listen, glory to God, to Gideon's army praying at 10 o'clock, it's an indication to us that we made progress. Because you might not have, a multitude of people that you can see at this time, but if you start praying like that, before you know it, glory to God, they will come from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The strength of any church is its prayer. Amen. Is his prayer. Amen. And so we can look at it, glory to God, and we can see what happens when we come to the altar. So when you have a microphone, Sister Tanya, when you have a microphone, you know you're going to be giving thanks and you're going to be returning glory to God. You just close your eyes like Brother Stephen just did. Just close your eyes and go to praising and thanking God. Hallelujah. Can we give it up for Brother Stephen? I thank God for the Williams, glory to God. They are an asset to this ministry. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. As we continue to go and as we continue to grow, hallelujah, I want to thank all of you, glory to God, for what you do. Hallelujah, Sister Teresa on the music. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for that. That was awesome. Liberty saved me. Amen. Yeah. So we praise God. We have a keyboard here, and God's going to send us somebody to play.
Amen. Yes.
Are y'all breathing?
Amen. Yes.
We do it by faith. We got drums here.
Yes.
And God's going to send somebody to play.
Yes.
Are y'all breathing?
Yes.
Amen. You remember I stood and told you those drums was going to be over here? And you came a couple weeks later and the drums were sitting there, right?
Yes.
Amen. We do everything that we do and we do it by faith. Amen.
Amen.
And guess what? So far, it's working. Glory
our
to God.
God's a mighty God. He is a provider.
If you say it to somebody, I mean, even to some pastors, when you talk about the numbers and then you talk about what you do, glory to God, what God is doing in your midst, amen, they just shake their head. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. David had 400 men that he trained, and then 200 was added to the 400. But when they went out to pursue against the Amalekites, only the 400 went because the 400 were trained. Amen. The 200 were not. Amen. Hallelujah. The house of God, glory to God, is a place of training. Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
It's a place of training. We are learning, hallelujah, how to flow. Glory to God in the kingdom of God. We've established prayer. Glory to God. We got praise on the altar, giving thanks. Hallelujah. And returning glory to God. Hallelujah. We can get solid. Glory to God in both of those areas. Everybody say prayer.
Prayer.
Praise.
Praise.
Amen. And we got, glory to God, Sister Yolanda here too.
Yeah.
Are y'all breathing?
Amen.
Amen. And Brother Douglas.
Amen.
Sister Maria and their family, glory to God. Hallelujah. God brought in a whole family at one time.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
He's
Amen.
Great, greatly to be
Hallelujah.
Praised.
And he's got great work for you to do. There's great work for you to do. You're not sitting where you're sitting by accident.
Amen.
Amen. And don't you look at anything else except God. Don't look at yourself. You look at God and what God is doing. Glory to God. Because, you know, on the broadcast this week, I was preaching on willingness. Do you know that God has promised us all of these things in this book that he would do for us, and some people ain't even willing to get it? He said that's what it first take, a willing mind. All you got to do is be willing. Lord, I'm willing. We look at ourselves and say, I got to do that. No, I have to be willing to do it. Glory to God. The people will be willing in the day of God's power. Are y'all hearing me? He told Moses, he said, go get the people. You gather them together who are of a willing heart. Because if you are available, God has the ability. So it's not ability, it's availability. If you're available and willing, God will do it. Moses said, man, go down there and talk to Pharaoh with a stick. He said, Moses, if you go down there, I'll be with your mouth. Amen. So it's not us, it's how much of God, amen, is demonstrated through us. Are y'all free?
Amen.
Okay, don't get quiet on me, it's Sunday. If you can't preach on Sunday, ain't gonna be preaching no kind of day, right? Amen. So I'm going at it, amen.
Yes.
Like I am for the day, glory to God,
oh,
amen.
You
can be quiet if you want to. Glory to Lord. Hallelujah. Let me show you something. Glory to God. I'm gonna show you this as a church, okay? Are y'all ready?
Amen.
Joel 1. Glory to God. The prophet Joel. Amen, and thank God, Sister Johnson is here today.
Amen.
Sister Monica's mom, we thank God for you. It's always a pleasure when you're here with us. Glory to God, and thank God for Sister Monica. You know, sometimes you have to drag her, but she's coming on real good. Amen. Now, Kimmy and Miss Johnson laugh, and they tell us, oh my God. All right, glory to God, they both laughing. Amen. Y'all pray for me, okay?
Oh, yeah.
All right, Stephen. The cops get cold, man. You better be careful. We ready? Joel 1 and verse 12. Sister Yolanda, you got your scripture from last week? Stephanie didn't bring you the scripture.
I sent
it to you. I said, this is her.
She told me she had it, but we didn't.
Okay. She got it. She got your scripture from last week. Yeah. And they said, Jamaica, we're going on Ebo.
Technical difficulties.
We good? Go ahead and read it. Amen. Joel 1.
Joel 1, verse 12.
Start at verse 11.
Joel 1, verse 11. Be ye ashamed, O ye husbandmen. How, O ye vine dressers, for the wheat and for the barley. Because the harvest of the field is perished.
Uh-huh.
The vine is dried up, and the fig tree languishes. The pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field are withered.
Why?
Because joy is withered away from the sons of men.
He said because of the lack of joy, the harvest is drying up. Glory to God. Who want their harvest to dry? Huh? He said, without joy, the harvest start drying up. Glory to God. We say that in church. Come with joy, amen. Hallelujah. Live life with joy. Be happy, glory to God. Hallelujah. Rejoice. Because God, hallelujah, is planning no defeats for you, but only victories.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So just, Lord, Lord, give me joy. Practice joy. Practice having joy. Practice having joy. Practice having joy. Practice having joy. When I went to the eye doctor, right? Glory to God. I told the lady, I've been seeing at the eye doctor for, I guess, about 4 years. And I say, I love you. She didn't know how to take it. She said, oh, I love you too. Glory to God. Hey, glory to God. He ain't come, he happy. What's he happy about? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The lady in the bank says, oh, you dressed up, you look pretty nice today. I said, I knew I had to come to your window. And I wasn't going to come to your window not dressed up. Amen? Hallelujah. So we had a good laugh. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's be joyful. I'm telling you, we got some good stuff. Amen. Hallelujah. In the kingdom of God. So you might as well go ahead on and rejoice.
Amen.
I mean, God brought you this far. Glory. He brought you this far. Glory to God. I'm 58 years old. I ain't never been hungry. I ain't never been outdoors. I ain't never been naked. Glory to God. I mean, for 58 years, God has shown himself faithful in my life. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And sometimes, glory to God, I didn't love myself. Glory to God, but God loved me anyway.
Amen.
He was good anyhow. Glory to God. And he's still good. God doesn't change. Glory to God. So we might as well be happy and rejoice. Especially this good news we get.
Amen.
This good news right here.
Amen.
This is good news. Glory to God. I don't have no bad report for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Brother Douglas testified to me today. Glory to God. They say his grandmother had how long to live?
24 to
72
hours.
And that was last Sunday.
Right.
Amen.
And she still lived.
Amen.
Our God is mighty God.
Are y'all here with me?
Amen.
God is answering prayer. He write these things to you that your jaw might be full. Glory to God, and that your jaw remain. And so shall you be my disciple. Glory to God. Jesus' disciples are joyful.
Hallelujah.
Are y'all hearing me? He called his disciples one day. He said, do y'all remember all the time in these 3.5 years you've been walking with me? They said, yeah. They said, did you lack anything? They said, no, nothing. So if his disciples then, and his disciples now, glory to God, they get the same thing.
Amen.
Say it with me.
I
will
not
lack anything.
Lack anything.
Because
the Lord
is my shepherd.
Is my shepherd.
Isn't that what the Bible say?
That's
the
what
Lord
says.
Is my shepherd.
And I shall not want.
Hallelujah.
What, you think that's just a pretty poem? That's a covenant with God. I'm talking about it's strong too. It's stronger than battery acid. The Lord is my shepherd. And I shall not want. What is want? I shall not lack. He said before that, he said the young lions, they lack and they suffer hunger, but they that serve the Lord, glory to God, shall not lack any good thing. He said the lion may get hungry and the lion may lack, but if you walk with God, you will not lack any good thing. Can I get a witness in here?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Can I get a strong amen?
Amen. Glory.
You got to declare these things over your life. You got to open your mouth. Listen, ain't nobody going to die for you. You're going to die for yourself. You might as well talk for yourself.
Hello.
You can sit in the grocery store parking lot. Oh, I ain't going in there. I ain't you're going, or you can get out your car and go in the grocery store, glory to God, and get what you need to eat. Are y'all breathing? It's not going to come out and just, you got to get out the car and go in the store. Isn't that right? You can't eat no wish sandwich. I wish. No, get out the car. Go in the store and buy what it is that you want to eat. Don't sit there in the parking lot wishing. Glory to God. Get in the game. Glory to God. Don't be a bench warmer. Glory to God. Get in the game. Hey, Lord, listen. Glory to God. I'm telling you right now. When I was kicking that heroin and I was in that place and I was, oh my God, I was in so much pain. And you know, you fall asleep, a real terrible nightmares from not putting yourself in a dream state all of those years, and finally all them dreams just flooding you down. I didn't know Jesus. My grandmama did though. I said, I don't know you. I don't even know if you exist. But if you do, and you get me out of this here, I promise you, I'll serve you for the rest of my life. I'll bow down. Now, if you want to know why I bow down the way that I do, glory! If you want to know why I love him like I love him, glory to God. He miraculously did that day.
Yes.
Glory to God. I'm talking about that hour that I asked him. He showed me who he was. You get the word of God and you take it, glory to God, for your own life, glory to God, and take responsibility for your destiny and open up your mouth, glory to God, and create it. I'm telling you right now, oh, the Bible up here now. I was looking for Jesus up here on the cross. He died and was buried for us. And he rose again
the
third day for our justification. In other words, we were not justified, glory to God. And he the one now. He bought the church, he bought it with his blood. And he the one said, you can have whatever you say. Say, I can.
Have.
Whatever I say. So if you don't want it, don't say it.
Don't say it. Put a check on that mouth.
Don't be walking around, I'm so broke, I owe myself $2. No, cut that out.
Speak life and speak it abundantly.
Because broke that's looking around the corner. Oh, they just called me. Oh, here I go. Child, I'm sick. Oh, my God, I'm so sick. I don't know what to do. Sickness peeping around the corner. Oh, he called me. Glory to God. They just come and just bombard your house, bombard your life. Glory to God. And one lady thought she would prophesy. She said, every year we get ready to go on vacation, all the kids get sick. Just watch and see what I tell you. All and every year. Before they get ready to go on vacation, them poor little kids get so sick. Because she done spoken into their life. But she thinks she prophesied.
Right.
Amen?
Right.
But that's what you call prophet lying. All right, y'all ready for a scripture?
Thank you,
Jesus. Okay, I got one for you.
Huh?
Amen?
Amen.
Sister Tamisa, would you take Romans 9:23-26. We did this scripture before, I believe, on Wednesday night.
Yes, sir.
All right? But we're gonna do it again. All right, like Luther had to do it again. All right, glory to God. We're gonna do it again. Amen. Are y'all breathing? See, faith don't come by hearing or having heard. Faith come by hearing, and hearing, and hearing, and hearing. See, Brother Keith, you keep on hearing it, it just keep producing faith in you. Glory to God. And one day that thing just dawned on you. So, ooh, Lord, glory to God. That word, I got that. That's mine right there. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I believe Brother Dixon had Romans 8:32 on Wednesday night. Glory to God. If God spared not his son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not really give us all things by him? All right. Brother Fitz, would you take First Corinthians 1 and verse 9. Okay. Brother Keith, you have 1 Corinthians 1 and 30. My man, you're going to have 1 Corinthians 2, 9 through 12. Sister Tanya, you have 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 16. Sister Yolanda, you don't have 1 Corinthians 3 and verse 9. Amen. Amen. Sister Johnson, you have 1 Corinthians 3 and verse 16. And Sister Kimmy, you're going to have 1 Corinthians 3, 21 through 23. Brother Douglas, you have 1 Corinthians 4 and 10. Sister Maria, you're going to have 1 Corinthians 6 and 15. My brother, you're going to have 1 Corinthians 6, 19 through 20. You look around, you, that one right there, you. 19 through 20, you got it? Okay, hallelujah. My sister, you're gonna have 1 Corinthians 12 and 13. You got it? My brother there, you're gonna have 1 Corinthians 12 and 27. Brother Dixon, you have 1 Corinthians 15, 57. Sister Monica has 2 Corinthians 1, 18 through 22. And Brother Stephen will have 2 Corinthians 2 and verse 11. Amen. Y'all ready? Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Y'all quiet. Is it cold or is it hot? Y'all just quiet today.
Let there be peace in the valley.
Romans 9:23-26.
Uh-huh. What is it?
Yeah,
what is it?
And that he might make known the riches of his glory.
What'd you say? What did he call us? Did you see what he called us? What God called us? Vessels of mercy. Say it with me. I'm a vessel of mercy. I carry the mercy of God.
Oh, his mercy.
Oh, his mercy. Well, y'all know God done got mad. God ain't got it. Where you get this stuff from? God get tired of y'all. How God gonna get tired?
Don't think it's gonna happen.
His anger is but for a moment, but his mercy endured forever. So why are people majoring on his anger, which is but for a moment, and ain't talking nothing about his mercy? Oh, it's by the mercies of the Lord we not consumed. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I'm telling you, there's a brand new mercy that comes to you every single day.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
He's dealing with this, the hot seed of God, which is comes into the new covenant that we have. It's translated agape. Glory to God. That's unconditional love. Glory to God. You can't separate God and the love and the mercy. Everybody say he's merciful.
He is merciful. Oh, my God.
God have mercy on you.
Thank you.
Glory to God. When stuff used to get tough, glory to God. I can remember them days now. Stuff get tough in the church. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And them little old ladies be sitting up there in the front. You know when stuff get tough? You know what they start just saying? Oh, Lord, have mercy. That's what they would be saying. I used to wonder as a little boy, what did they want to tell my dad? Oh, Lord, have mercy. You see, you come to them and tell them something bad done happened, or you think something bad done happened, the first thing they would say was, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy.
Thank you. I thank you.
Have mercy. And he made us vessels of mercy.
Thank you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Which he had been afore prepared unto glory. You see, everything God does in our life is for his glory.
Hallelujah. Let it shine.
Okay, go on. I'm interrupting you from reading.
Even us whom he had called, not of the Jews only, but also of the Gentiles, as he said also in Osei.
That's actually Hosea.
Hosea, okay.
But it's Osei Paul uses, isn't it?
I will call them my people, which were not my people, and her beloved, which was not beloved. And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, yea, ye are not my people, there shall they be called the children of the living God.
Oh, the children of the living God. He called us the children of the living God. He called us to this to be first vessels of mercy. And we vessels of mercy. Glory to God. Say the mercy is working today.
The mercy is working today. Thank you. I give you thanks, and I give you praise for glory.
We just better hope the mercy working, right?
Yeah.
How many of us need the mercy from God? Have mercy, Lord.
You, my God. Yeah.
All right, glory to God. We doing good. Hallelujah. Time, yeah. Glory to God. What do you have? Brother Fishburne, what do you have?
1 and 9?
1 Corinthians 1:9.
1 Corinthians 1:9. God is faithful.
God is what?
God is faithful.
Thank you.
God is what?
He is faithful.
Somebody say it with me. Great.
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 Lord is your faithfulness.
Is your faithfulness.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you.
Is God faithful or not?
Yes, he is.
God is faithful. Let me show you how faithful God is. Every morning, glory to God, that sun rises in the east and set in the west. Glory to God. Hallelujah. On time every single day.
Right.
Hallelujah. Summer always follows spring. Fall always follows summer. And winter always comes. Glory to God. Are y'all hearing me?
Oh, yes.
When it start getting cold, glory to God, the birds, you can tell, they start flying south. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament show forth his handiwork. God is so faithful. Let me tell you something. God, you can count on God. You can trust in God. You can trust God more than that chair you sitting in. Ain't nobody checked that chair to see if it'll hold you. You just trusted that it would, didn't you? Just came and just plopped right down and just knew that chair was gonna hold you. Glory to God. But God's more faithful than that chair. Did you hear what I said?
God is faithful. Glory. Thank you, my God.
I got dressed to come bring on my God today. Hallelujah. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to brag on
Yes, glory to God.
Glory to God, because he's been good. Hallelujah. I can't hold back no more. Glory to God. I can't back back no more. Glory to God. I got to keep pushing forward. Glory to God, because God
is good.
By whom you were what?
Called unto the fellowship of his son, Jesus Christ.
Our Lord.
You were called to what?
Unto the fellowship of his son, Jesus Christ.
What a fellowship. Come bread and buttermilk. No. Glory to God. No. What? You've been called into the fellowship of God's son. Do you know this word here, koinonia? That's what this word is, taken from a Greek word called koinonia. And you know what it means? It means partnership. You've been called, and guess who you work for? Guess who we work for now? God and sons. We've been called into a partnership with him. And guess what? Glory to God. His part was to die. Our part was to benefit from his death. His part was get stripes on his back. Our part is to be healed. His part was he became poor. Our part is that we might be made rich.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, say it with me. I'm rich.
Thank you. I'm rich. Oh, glory. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you,
Jesus. I'm rich.
I am rich. I'm healed. Oh, glory.
I'm rich. I was in here. Glory to God, crawling around on this floor, crying. Glory to God, oh my God, hallelujah, like farming and cement. Glory to God, but I start saying what God said about me. Glory to God, I'm in partnership with him, and he's faithful. Started getting up in the morning, exalting him, and saying, Lord, you know what? Worry, why am I worried and you with me and you faithful?
Hello.
What I'm worried about?
Give me a prayer.
And God's faithful. That means when I step back and worry, I'm not counting his faithfulness. I'm not feeding on his faithfulness. I'm not feeding on God. He ain't letting us down. He ain't letting nobody down in this room. He's not letting you down. I'm telling you right now, God is faithful in your life. If you line up with him, if you partnership with him, Lord, I'm a partner with you. Glory to God. It's you who is at work in me. I make myself willing for you to be at work in me, and you will to do of your own good pleasure.
Thank you. Yes.
Your part ain't to play God.
That's true.
Yeah, and the people say, well, I got good news and bad news. Well, what's the bad news first? Now tell me the good news first. The good news is, God is alive and faithful and well and can do anything. Amen. Well, what's the bad news? You not him. You not him. Huh? Say it with me, say, I'm not him.
I'm not him.
Amen, Brother Keith. Glory to God. Brother Keith had 1 in 30. Ooh, wee. Glory to God. If thou canst believe, thou will see the glory of God. Go ahead, Brother King.
But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God made unto us wisdom and righteousness and
sanctification. Look at this here. You see
yes.
This right here? Look what it say, us.
Us.
We in the Bible.
Yes.
Us.
Wisdom.
Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us. What is he made unto us?
Wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption.
He what?
Made unto us.
So, I ain't liking none of this stuff. Christ has been made this to us. Wisdom. I have all the wisdom I need. And what I don't need, I can ask him. Glory to God. And he won't fuss at me for asking him. Give me wisdom in this situation, Lord. Lord, give me wisdom. Hallelujah. I thank you that Christ Jesus is made unto me. Don't let your branch and your crops out there wither now because you don't have no joy. This should make you happy.
Glory to God.
My God, this should make you happy.
Hallelujah.
Not ask.
Thank you, Lord.
I used to wonder as a little boy why the preacher was, I wonder where they are. I said, this is right here. Glory to God.
Don't leave it.
Do you see it? He made unto us wisdom and righteousness, sanctification and redemption. You can't change this. This is settled in heaven forever.
Hallelujah.
Us.
He made unto us. Get it in your soul. Get it in your heart. Get it in your mind.
Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus.
1 Corinthians 2, 9 through 12. And he a good reader. I'll be glad when I see him coming, glory to God, on Sunday morning, because he a good reader. And you know what? He willing to do it.
Amen. Yeah.
Somebody say willing.
Willing.
All right. Come on.
Your neighbor.
I got to see something. I got to hear something. No, but it ain't revealed to your eye. Your eyes ain't seen this. You ain't never seen what God won't do in your life. You ain't seen it. You have not, my God, hallelujah, we have no clue what God wants to do. That's why we got to be willing. Glory to God, and just keep right on walking in love and keep right on walking in faith. Are y'all breathing?
Yes.
Okay, go right ahead, my brother.
For God hath revealed him unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yet the deep things of God. Who what man knoweth the things of a man, seeing the spirit of man which is in him? Even so, the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God.
Who know it? The Spirit of God is the one that know it. He's the one who know it. He'll lead you right to it too. In all truth. He'll bring all things to your remembrance and he'll show you stuff to come. My God, the Spirit of God will take you out 6 months and say, hey, 6 months from now, this is where you're going to be. Glory to God. See, some people don't know. Glory to God, and they don't want to pay no attention. Glory to God to what the Spirit of God is telling them. He's telling us, sometimes he's telling you prepare because this is what's going to happen to you in 6 months. I want you to be ready for it. Glory to God. You know when God speaks to you and tell you, I got all of this stuff here waiting for you, but if I give it to you right now in the shape you in, I'd have to kill you. Really? God makes a promise to an Abram, but he fulfills it in an Abraham.
Hallelujah.
So by the time the promise of God is fulfilled in your life, you're a whole different person.
Amen.
Oh, I'm just going to stay. No, your destiny is over here. You stay the same if you want to. Your destiny is going to attack. I heard Benny Hinn say this, and my God, man, I just turned everything off. I had to sit there. He said the blessing will attack you. Your anointing will attack you because it's fixed for a specific purpose and for a specific time. Don't change. Stay the same way you are and think you're going to get to destiny. No, God, hallelujah. Well, I don't even get that jiggle wrestle with him all night long. He said, I ain't letting you go till you bless me. He said, what's your name? He said, Jacob. He said, that's your problem. Your name needs to be changed. And so he changed his name is Israel, and he said, you have prevailed, my God. And when Jacob went home, he went home in peace. Glory to God. Are y'all here with me?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Willingness is all it takes. God changed me. Somebody say, Lord.
Lord.
Fix me.
Fix me.
You can't stay no earth person. Tell me you're going to receive all these spiritual blessings and everything God got for you and just stay the same. Friend, let God change you. You can't change yourself. Let God change you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy. Hallelujah, tried and true. And with thanksgiving, I'll be a living. Hallelujah. Temple for you. This stuff is done by the Spirit. It's done by the Spirit. It's done by the Spirit. Brother Douglas, you sitting there by the Spirit, your family sitting here by the Spirit of God.
Amen.
And we might think it's one reason, but the Spirit of God, my Lord, the Holy Ghost is working all the time. Hallelujah, revealed to us by his Spirit. It's revealed to us by his Spirit. You ever have a hunch? It might be God. Glory to God. It just might be. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The Spirit. Okay, verse 12.
Now we have received not the Spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know things that are freely given to us of God.
Yes.
This is freely given to you. It's freely. I never see people in the natural when they get gifts. When they get gifts, look sad. Here, I just gave you a new Rolex. You see? Still walking around. What you say? Thank you, oh my God, thank you. That's how you receive a gift, eh?
Amen.
Isn't that how you receive a gift? You know, when children are little, some of them, not all of them, you have to teach them. Because they go to somebody else's birthday party and they get sour. Because the other child whose birthday it is, getting all the gifts, and they, you know, they only get one time a year, glory to God, and that ain't their time. But they upset because they think they should be in on it. Because children like to do what? They like to receive gifts. Isn't that right?
Amen.
And then we get grown and God gave us all this stuff. And I'm telling you, this stuff is freely given to us of God. It's freely given to us of God. Your eyes ain't seen it. Our ears haven't heard it. It hadn't been revealed into the heart of man, the things that are freely given to us of God. But look, when the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, when you start listening to the Holy Ghost, you live in the Word of God, you live in prayer and live in praise, the Holy Ghost will show you the things that are freely given to you of God.
Yes.
You know, for years, there's something in my life that I thought would be just too difficult to do. It just, until I got in my car. And what you do in your car? I just rode. And I said, enough was enough. Because I looked at this thing and seen how difficult it is. And I said, listen, Father God, I'm not doing this no more. I'm not doing it. I'm not considering nothing else. Nothing! I ain't consider the color of my skin. I ain't consider how tall I was or none of that. I ain't considering none of that. I'm releasing my faith for this to happen. And it's going to be left up to you. Do you know how easy that became? Once It was given over to God. Talked to the lady at the loan office. You know what she said? I'm going to get this done for you. What? And she said, you qualify for this amount of money. And guess what? The thing I wanted cost that amount of money that I got qualified for. Y'all breathing in here. Glory to God. I'm testifying how I make known his deed among the people. My eyes. I ain't going by my eyes. I ain't going by my ear. I ain't like, no. Him.
Him.
Him. Are y'all breathing?
Amen.
Oh, we got this all analyzed and figured out. No. It's by spirit. Okay, Sister Tanya, I got it. I'm getting better.
1 Corinthians 2:16.
Uh-oh. 2:16. Amen. Y'all here?
Amen.
I'm gonna bore y'all just a little bit longer, okay? Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Hang in there. Glory to God. What did it say?
For who hath known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ.
What kind of mind we got? What kind of mind?
Mind of Christ.
Say it with me. Say, I have.
The mind.
Of Christ.
Oh, thank you.
I have the mind of Christ. You have the mind of Christ. We have the mind of Christ. So I'm telling you right now, I ain't walking with God till I get alien lose my mind. I got the mind of Christ. I have the mind of Christ. I have the mind of Christ. I can remember from now to this time tomorrow. I had 100% recall memory. Adam, let me tell you something. Adam named every four-footed beast, creeping thing, fish of the sea, and fowl of the air. He gave them all a name. Which means now, how could you name all them fish up under the water? You had to go underwater, and you had to be able to stay underwater a long time. This was that first man that God created. Glory to God. Before he fell from his place of dignity, this man could go up under the water and look at them fish and give all them names. Which means he had to go up in the air too, unless the birds came there and landed in front of him. He had to go up in the air and see all the birds that was up there in the air. This man was phenomenal. Glory to God. The mind, glory to God of Christ. We had. Let it work. Get like Rachel. Make it do what it do. Y'all here?
Amen.
Okay, who next? Sister Lana? Glory to God. We have a mind of Christ.
1 Corinthians 3:9.
Uh-huh. It's not us, it's God in us. We are God's building.
Oh, God.
We are God's building.
Thank you.
We are God's building. And that building is not condemned. Sometimes there's a sticker up there say under construction, but glory to God, hallelujah, still God building. He is committed to do that. He's faithful. Okay, who next? Who next? Sister Johnson, you next? Somebody say the Spirit is in me.
The Spirit is in me.
Living the Holy Spirit is in me.
Oh, yeah. Living, flowing, alive and well.
Hallelujah. You gotta love this.
God, praise you.
Something else may be in you. You tell people that something might be in you, but the Holy Ghost in me. God living in me. I'm the temple of God. I'm the temple of God. Isn't it wonderful when we gather together all these temples of God?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And God is in us individually, and by God, then he moves in us corporately. Are y'all hearing me?
Yes.
Okay. Sister Kimmy. Amen. Okay, 3:21 through 23. Yeah, 3 and 21.
Me, not no man. Glory to man. For all things and.
All things is yours. Somebody say all things is mine.
All things are mine.
If the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein, and we are heirs and heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ, that means, glory to God, that all things are ours. Did you hear what I said? Okay, so Sister Kimmy, keep going.
Hallelujah.
22.
Whether Paul or Apollo or
Cephas,
the world or life or death or things present or things to come, all of yours.
All is yours.
Yes.
I remember when I first came around, the deacon used to get up, glory to God. I don't know how old the deacon was. The deacon had to be 100. He'd make 100 easy. He said, I looked all around me. All around me shine. He said, I asked King Jesus, is all this mine? Glory to God. Glory to God. They said, man, you got to stop laughing. The church. I said, I can't. Oh, the deacon get up and glory to God, start rapping like that. Glory to God. Is all this mine?
Hallelujah.
All things are yours. Okay, Brother Douglas. Thank you so much. Sister Kimmy, she did good. Praise God. Okay, which one you have? 1 Corinthians 4:18.
We are fools for Christ's sake. That you are wise for Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You Dishonorable?
No, honorable.
I wouldn't say that.
Mm-hmm. But we are despised. You see that? What he said?
We are despised.
You are what?
Wise.
Can you say it? Say, I'm wise.
I am wise in Christ.
You are what?
Strong.
I'm strong. Glory to God. And I'm honorable. Now, what are you talking about? I'm talking about the way God told us that we are, so that we can see this, believe it, and become it. So that we have a picture of who we are in the mind and in the insight of God, that we are strong, that we are wise, glory to God, that we are honorable. That's us. That's who we are. Well, you know, don't feel like that. Don't war against what God said with the way you feel. War against the way you feel with what God said.
Amen.
All right? Sister Maria, are you ready? I think you got 1 Corinthians 6 and 15. We moving right along, y'all.
Amen.
Amen. It ain't that bad. Time ain't that bad.
Praise God.
Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ?
Uh-huh.
Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an orla?
Heart.
God forbid.
Should I take God's temple and connect it to something else? No. We are members of Christ. We are members of Christ. Amen. All right. My brother, which one you got? Tell me your name again. I'm going to remember. What's your name?
Javion.
Did I say it right? Javion. All right, Javion. Glory to God. 2 weeks in a row, man, you done got you a scripture. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Which one do you have? 1 Corinthians 6, 19 through 20. Okay. Okay, go right ahead. Do it like you're on the playground, calling your friend. Hey! Your God. Okay?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hold on. He's not done yet. Good. Okay. You did good. Thank you. Thank you, Jeremy. Amen. You did good. Amen. Glorify. What? Glory. People think that's you. No. I'm willing to have God to be glorified in my body. I'm willing to have God glorified in my body.
My God.
Are y'all hearing me?
He is my God.
I praise God, but I really wasn't convinced that I would glorify God when I was in that 78 Chevette. Y'all don't even know about it. They don't think they even make no Chevettes no more. It was a 78 Chevette. And it had a big old hole in the floor. You could see when you ride down, you could see the ground when you were riding. And then people would say, well, what's he shouting like that for? I had one suit. It was blue. I wore yellow. See, because we had church Sunday, we had church Tuesday, we had church Friday. So I wear yellow, One day with that blue suit, red with that blue suit, and then blue with that blue suit. I was trying to make that suit look different. Now we put that Clinton in the cleaner. That man said, "Man, you keep cleaning this suit this much, it's gonna tear it up." But I get in there, my God, let hit the drum, and I'd be shouting, "Glory to God," because I was convinced, glory to God, that I would glorify God in my body. Glory to God, this ain't it. This is not it. I start praising him for what it is. Are y'all breathing?
Amen.
That's how you get there. That's how you stop your harvest from withering up. Glory to God, to be joyful and thankful. Lord, I thank you that you bought me with a price.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And I'm in this earth to glorify you in my body.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to glorify you. I'm going to glorify you. I am going to glorify you. Glory be to God.
Glory, 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 glory. My God.
And nobody here is permitted to not glorify God. When the people come look around your house, they look around and you tell them, "If your God not working, try mine."
Amen.
Are y'all here with me? Change God, man. God is by better. Did you hear what I said? He is a, my God. He told the children of Israel, he said, "Y'all getting ready to go over to worship me. So here's what you do. I want you to borrow all of Pharaoh and them gold." So they borrowed the gold out of Egypt. And then they went out. And somebody might have been thinking, "Well, how are we going to pay them back?" You can't. You have to pay them back. You have to pay your creditor back if they dead. He knew he was going to drown them in that Red Sea. The ones that they got the gold, they come down there and see God drown them. Amen?
Amen.
Say it with me. Say, "Lord.
Lord.
Drown my creditors.
Drown my creditors." He's a mighty God.
Drown them, glory to God. You got to look at the mountain of debt. And you got to let God drown that debt for you.
Amen.
You got to let him take, you got to believe. You got to believe God. You got to believe it. You a believer. Amen. You ever seen the believer that didn't believe?
No.
Okay, my sister, we doing good. Which one you have? You got 1 Corinthians 12 and 13. Now listen to her. She a good reader. Somebody say it with me. Say, "Readers.
Readers.
Are leaders.
Are leaders."
Okay, here we go.
Whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one spirit.
Amen.
Yes.
She read it like that. She gonna be the president of the United States. That's her aspiration. That's her dream.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Don't let nobody crush your dream.
Yes.
Glory to God. Believe God. Hallelujah. Just believe God. All things are possible to them that believe. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Keep reading. You read. I was in the barber shop, right? Glory to God. And I was reading this magazine across the front of his head in big letters. Glory to God. Texas. And so one of the guys in there say, "OG," that's what they call me. And "OG, you'll read anything, won't you?" I said, "Yeah, I just read an article in here where there's a man in Texas that has a ranch the size of Chicago." I wouldn't have known that if I wasn't reading that magazine. I put a $100 bill in this young guy And I gave him a book. I put a $100 bill in the middle of it. And I come back 6 months later. I said, how was that book? Oh, yeah, that was a good book. OG, that was a good book. I said, give me the book. And I went to open the book and took the $100 bill out of that. If he had been going through that book, he would have seen that $100 bill. Now, people scared of books. You don't want people breaking in your car? Leave a book on the seat. For some reason, they see them books and go the other way. Are y'all hearing me? You can't be a slave when you read. Frederick Douglass told his master, he said, Master, show me how to read. You know what Master told him? He said, Frederick, if I teach you how to read, you will be of no use to me. Glory to God. You can't be enslaved when you read. Glory to God. Read. Glory to God. Give yourself to read. Glory to God. Okay, my brother. I know I got to go, right?
Now ye are the bodies of Christ in member, in
particular. Now who are we?
Body of Christ.
And members in what?
Particular.
Thank you, sir. That was good. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Who next? The body of Christ. Members in particular. Okay.
1 Corinthians 15 and 57.
Uh-huh.
But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
ETH means what?
Continually.
Perpetually, continually, always doing it. He didn't give us one victory. He giveth us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. He giveth us the victory. David told that Goliath, he said, listen, you come out here, glory to God. I come out here in the name of the Lord of hosts. I'm going to take your head and I'm going to chop it smooth off and I'm going to feed it to the birds of the air. Because he gave me victory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, yes. He gives me the victory. So many people doubt him. I can't live without him. That is why I love him so. He's so real to me. Real, real. Y'all didn't know I could sing, did you? Hallelujah. Jesus is real to me. Oh, yes. How am I doing? I'm on key? No. Glory to God. But I got the melody. Glory to God. Amen. All right. Don't make fun of me. Sister Tanya, just because you can sing. Now, don't make fun of me. Okay, I did good? Okay, good. Hallelujah. She a singer, so she know if I did good. Oh, yes. He gives me the victory. So many people doubt him. I can't live without him. That is why I love him so. He's so real to me.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody say, thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
That gives me the victory.
The victory.
Through Jesus Christ.
Through Jesus Christ.
My Lord.
Hallelujah. Thanking you.
Okay, Jesus. Sister Monica.
2 Corinthians 1:18-22.
Uh-huh.
But as God is true.
God is what?
It's true.
You mean to tell me God is true?
It's true.
God can't deny himself. He's not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man he should repent. He said that he'll do it. He spoke it, and he will make it good.
Yes, Lord.
You can count on what God said. My covenant I will not break, neither will I alter the thing that is going forth out of my mouth. But as God is true.
Our word toward you was not yea and nay, For the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who was preached among you by us, even by me, and Silvanus, and Timotheus, was not yea and nay, but in him was yea. For all the promises of God in him are yea, and in him amen, unto the glory of God by us. Now he which establisheth with you in Christ and hath anointed us is God, who hath also sealed us and given the earnest of the Spirit.
You didn't take no extra scripture, did you?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, cool.
That be it.
Because the word will get good to you like that. You want an extra one. Listen, friend. Listen. When God says to you, I give you the victory, and you say, I have the victory, God says, yes, yes, amen. What is he saying? God is saying to you, yes, yes, so be it. So when you walk away from the promises of God, tell me I got good religion. Certainly, Lord. But you ain't dealing with the promises of God. I feel. And I ain't got nothing to do with how you feel. Glory to God. He just tell you, come up there, Lord, I feel this your poor, weak, humble servant. You, first of all, after he done told you not to say that, you're going to go say that to him. That's enough if your parents told you, don't say that word now. You don't say that. And then you get away from them, and you up and down the street, you say all that stuff.
All right.
Right. Right. Exactly. Imagine your parents heard the way you talk when they told you not to use them words. Now God done told us not to use them words. And here we come walking up in God's presence and say to him what he just told us not to say. Yeah. He said, let the weak say I'm what?
Strong.
Let the poor say I'm
rich.
Hallelujah.
So if I say I'm strong, God, Father, I thank you that I'm strong. I thank you that I'm rich. Guess what God says? Because he the one says
yes, yes, and amen.
Got it, make it up. He said, yes, yes. So be it. Find you a word from God that fits your situation and your issue. Yeah. Glory to God, and find out what he promised and go up before him and say, let me tell you how strong this is. One day God told Moses, he said, listen, I'm going to kill all of these people and you and I are going to start over. Just go ahead, Moses. And then I'm going to kill all of them, and you and I are going to start fresh. You know what Moses told God? He said, you will not. Huh? You going to tell God he will not? He said, you will not. And the Lord said, why won't I? And Moses said to him, you promised Abraham, Isaac and Jacob that you wouldn't.
Yes.
And the Bible says that God repented of the evil that he thought to do against Israel. That's how strong his covenant is. That's how strong his promise is. His promises are yes, yes, and amen. All of heaven and earth will be destroyed before one period or one comma, glory to God, will pass away from God's word, as he is true, glory to God. We ain't preaching no yes and no.
Right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We preaching you can be pitiful or powerful, but you can't be both.
Right.
Right.
Right. Hallelujah. Oh, God made God. No, God will do what he said he would do. And you can, I'm telling you, you can count them. All right, I'm almost done. I got one more. I already had mine.
Okay, 2 Corinthians 2 and verse 11. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices.
Right.
The only way he can get the advantage over you or I is that we be ignorant to his devices.
Right.
And one thing he does not want you dealing with, and that is that which is written. Because when he come out there on that mountain and Jesus had fasted 40 days, glory to God, and he was going to tempt him, he was going to test him, he was going to try him. Do you know what Jesus run him off that mountain with?
His written word.
Not what you heard said. I heard, just tell the devil what I heard.
It is written.
He said, oh, you going by what you heard, huh? Instead of telling me what it's written. It's written that me and my children are for signs and wonders in the earth. It's written, glory to God, I once was young and now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor a seed begging bread. No evil shall befall me, and neither shall any plague come nigh my dwelling. It's written, devil. It's written that I have power to tread on you, over you and scorpions, and over all of your power, and nothing you can do to hurt me. You can't hurt me. Jesus said, you cannot hurt me. It's written. You better back up.
Oh, it's a benefit. It is written.
I don't want to talk to the devil like that. He don't have no power. No, you don't tell me. Jesus said, I got all power. They all mean all.
Oh.
That means he didn't leave him in. His devices are trickery and lies. And he can get you to think it, and he can get you to believe it. He can't do anything to you apart from fear that God can do without faith. God operates by faith. He operates by fear. Everybody say, fear not.
Fear not.
You know, fear not is in the Bible 366 times. That's for one for every day of the year, and an extra one in case you need it. Are y'all breathing? Fear is of the devil. God is a God of faith. Father, I'm so happy. Glory to God, the day that you, my God, I say
thank you,
my refuge, my fortress, my God.
You are my refuge.
And in you do I trust. I give you praise and give you glory for how alive your word is. Hallelujah, how powerful it is. And Father God, as we look at our identity in Christ Jesus, I thank you and I praise you right now, Father God, that you be glorified in every single one of us,
yes,
every single
yes,
life,
yes,
in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we have prayed and give thanks. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen and amen.
Sister Kimmy, if you'll come up, glory to God, I want to pray for you as I'm living. Glory to God. Hallelujah, by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want y'all to, glory to God, you that believe in that. All right? All y'all believe. But I want you to extend your hand. Glory to God.
I thank you, Jesus.
I don't need this no more. Y'all can hear me.
You are my God.
Can you hear me now?
You praise. Oh, glory to you, my Lord, my Savior, my Redeemer. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to you, my God. Oh, hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. You are mighty in this land. You are the healer and work of the Lord. My God, my God, my God.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, I just thank you. I thank you. I thank you for my sister. I thank you for who you are in her life. I thank you, Father God, for moving, hallelujah, right now. by your Spirit, Father, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet, Father. Hallelujah, I release your miracle working power. And I decree and declare, hallelujah, that this is her day, Father God, of a miracle, a divine intervention by you. Father, I thank you right now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. What the enemy meant for evil, I thank you that you meant it for good. And Father God, this is the day you have made. And we will rejoice. And we will be glad. And be exalted. Can we not be exalted, Father? Be exalted. Be exalted. And I give you praise right now, Father God. Hallelujah. For the restoration, Father God, of the healing. Hallelujah to the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I praise you today, my God.
I thank you, Jesus.